Ladies and gentlemen, I'm so excited to welcome two very special guests who will be presenting the award to Tom. Please help me in welcoming members of No Doubt, Tony Kanal and Adrian Young.
Hi. This is so cool. I first met Tom 27 years ago when he called the phone number on the flyer, as you heard already. We put up at our rehearsal space saying we were looking for a guitar player. In walks this heavy metal loving guy with long curly hair who had actually studied music seriously. He shredded on guitar and took the musicianship of our band to the next level. That long-haired metalhead is now one of our closest friends. The longer I know Tom, the more I admire him. His passion for music, business, design, and the ocean are only trumped by the love he has for his awesome wife, Mika, and his three boys, Ace, Rio, and Koa. I learn from Tom every day. He is considerate and sensible, intelligent, and well-read. His eternal optimism is nothing short of infectious, especially in times when that positivity is needed. We have toured around the world and back again, and besides being on stage, some of the best times we have shared were the conversations we've had as we walked the streets of so many distant cities together, hashing out the complexities of life under the Eiffel Tower or the Manhattan skyline. We've had an incredible journey from our Orange County public school roots to where we are today. I look forward to many more musical adventures and family vacations with Tom. It is an honor to call him my friend, my bandmate, and my brother. This award is much deserved and well earned.
Wow. I don't know what else I can add to that, so I won't. Just kidding. Are you nervous that I'm gonna embarrass you? Tom Dumont receiving a Lifetime Achievement Award. Really? No, in all seriousness, no one deserves it more. Although it's quite impressive that you're getting a Lifetime Achievement Award, but only half of your life is over. I met Tom in the late 80s when I auditioned for No Doubt, and I was terrified at that audition. Very terrified. But here was a man, he was very kind, soft-spoken. He was intimidating in his prowess of his instrument, but he was very welcoming, and I thank you for that, because that was one of the most stressful days of my life. But after that, we became roommates for a while, and we were kind of like brothers. We even fought like brothers, which is strange but true. It's kind of funny to look back on that now. But speaking of a brotherhood, the three of us boys here, we have a bond that's very special and unique. And like Tony said, we learn a lot from each other. And I'm very thankful to have that connection with these two gentlemen. Watching Tom grow from the beginning of his adulthood until now has been a real treat. He's a fine man. He's a loving husband. He's a father who is the perfect example of what one should be. And he's a loyal friend and one heck of a guitar player. I can honestly say I'm a better human for knowing Tom, and the world is a better place for having him in it.
Ladies and gentlemen, Tom Dumont.
Thank you. Well, this is, you know, it's overwhelming. One of the things about that makes me feel comfortable about being a guitar player is that I don't have to speak or sing on stage. So, you know, thank you to the Irvine Public Schools Foundation and to NADA for asking me to be here and for honoring me. I am honored, I'm humbled. You know, it's an incredible thing. And I prepared a speech that I should read, but it's kind of brief. But I'm happy to be honored. Thank you. It's incredible to see these films and to see my career. It's weird, you know. I've done it. I've been in No Doubt for 27 years. It's been a long road, you know. I graduated from Woodbridge High School, 30 years ago. So it's been a long road, you know. And to relate it back to Irvine Schools, I should really read what I've written, but. I had a great childhood, and I started at El Camino Real as a kindergartner, and graduated from Woodbridge, and to be honest, I was not a great student I was a different kind of thinker, but I loved learning, and I loved my teachers, and especially in junior high school and high school. There was a forum for someone who loved music to play music, you know, in school. And it's part of what's so important, I think, about what everyone in this room is doing here tonight is raising money to make our schools better and to directly affect our kids, you know, and the kids in the community and kids who aren't our kids, you know. It's a great thing. And in my opinion, the reason, you know, the other reason that music education is so important in school is because music has a power to lift our spirits, and music is its own reward. So, thank you so much. Thank you, Adrian and Tony. I'm surprised you guys are here. We were in the studio last week making music, which is amazing. Thank you to my parents, Fred and Sharon, and my brother John, who's here, and my wife Mika, and to the Irvine Public Schools Foundation. Thank you very much.